Hey guys, Darth Gloak here, back with part one of our brand new B game, Battlefield 1. Campaign is what we will be doing. Now, I know what you're thinking. Wait a minute, weren't we doing Battlefield 3 campaign just a minute ago? Okay, well, funny story. So, my Battlefield is corrupted, okay? Now, it has been corrupted since I owned it, since I bought it, back on the 360 when it was newer. It has always been corrupted. It never remembers who I am. It never remembers that I'd played before. It always re-shows up that all of my DLC that I have is all brand new. I always have to readjust the brightness. All of it does that. It's always done that to me. Okay, well, one little mistake, a little faux pas on my part, is that I didn't remember. It doesn't save campaign. It doesn't save your campaign progress because it doesn't know that I've done it before because it's corrupted. So our campaign progress is completely gone. So what I'm going to do is we are going to do the Battlefield 1 campaign instead, because the original reason that I wanted to do it is because I do think the Battlefield games are superior shooters to the Call of Duty campaigns. Or, that means they're to Call of Duty. I like Battlefield more than Call of Duty. Because there's destructible environments, you're more likely to work together as a squad. The sound is like twice as good as what Call of Duty is. In Battlefield, it feels scary to be shot at. In Call of Duty, it's just like, oh, I'm being shot at. Like, it's just, you realize it's happening, but it doesn't actually scare you, right? Well, in Battlefield, it scares you. It does feel intense, it feels scary. Call of Duty doesn't feel like that. Now, don't get me wrong, I like Call of Duty. You guys can look at my game reviews of the Black Ops, you know, franchise, and I really do like it. But if you're trying to go for just the better shooter, play Battlefield. Now, the one thing that Call of Duty has that Battlefield does not is, Call of Duty has bots, so you can load up a map and play against bots. Well, you can't do that in Battlefield, and that's my biggest gripe against it, is that you can't just play offline against bots, like on a regular map. Otherwise, I would probably rarely play Call of Duty, and I would always be playing Battlefield all the time, if that was the case. And on top of the destructible environments, the better sound and everything, there's vehicles. And it's just, there's vehicles and planes, and it's just better. So if it was up to me, I would always play Battlefield, but you can't have bots, therefore that's why I play Call of Duty. But anyway, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete our Battlefield 3 video, and I'm going to put up this one instead. Now, I want to have Battlefield represented. Now, Battlefield 1's campaign was really good. Of course, the graphics are, you know, to drool, you know, are drool-worthy. Now, of course, at some point, maybe we will do Battlefield 3's campaign, but if it happens, it'll have to be that we play it in one sitting. Otherwise, if we don't start it and then play it all the way through, we won't have it again, because we can't go back and resume it. So that's the only way it'll work, is if I sit and record it in one sitting. That's a lot of space. That's a lot. It's like 6 hours is the approximate time to beat it, is what everyone's saying. So that's like sitting and playing a campaign for 6 hours. And so I don't have a problem with that, but space-wise, that's a long video. So what I would do is that I would cut it probably into at least 3 pieces, and then upload the pieces is probably how I would do that. But regardless, that's a lot. That's something we will consider in the future. But for now, I will replace what we have. And I know Battlefield 1 works. We also at some point will be doing Battlefield 4's campaign, because that one also works. It's just Battlefield 3 has been corrupted for me. It always has been. And I wasn't thinking. So anyway, now we are playing offline in Battlefield 1 today. The reason why is because there is a 12 gigabyte update, and I don't want to update it, especially considering that that's wasted space on my hard drive, because we're only here for the campaign, and all of that update is just going to be multiplayer crap, which means nothing to me, because on top of the fact that I don't have Xbox Live, and on top of that, there is no reason for me to stick around, because you can't just, you know, fight the bots. There is no bots, so that's the reason that it doesn't matter. So we are playing offline, so no achievements will be popping for us. If we get any achievements at all, they will pop up for me later on. So anyway, we are going to go ahead and move forward with this. Sorry about that, guys, if you were really interested in Battlefield 3. I will be deleting that video and deleting that playlist, because I don't want to have incomplete playlists. I kept a Skyrim one that we discontinued when I first started doing stuff, because I don't know, I did like 4 videos or something on it, and I didn't want to delete that many. So anyway, not the point. So here we go, let's do the campaign. This campaign was really, really good. It was just really, really good, and it was awesome. So I have mentioned before that I'm a big history buff. I mentioned that before, that I, before I went to public school, I was homeschooled for a lot of my youth, And my mom allowed me to... A big part of that was that I got to study whatever I wanted a lot of the time. That I would pick... I would pick something, and then I would study that. I would be allowed to study that thing, that I would just be allowed to do whatever I wanted on it. So what I did is that I studied pirates for like a year. I studied pirates like real, like crazy. I knew all the major pirates. I knew all kinds of crazy facts about them, and I still retain some of those. Well, another thing that I did is I would pick wars. So I heavily studied World War I and World War II. I studied the crap out of both of those. At one point, I knew the dates of all the major battles. I knew all of that stuff. And it was really cool to me. Okay, well, because I studied World War I when I was a wee little lad, it is incredibly interesting to me. So this game, I think, does a great job with capturing how it probably felt. Now, of course, I don't know how it felt. It happened over 100 years ago. However, but it's just, I think that this game does a great job with capturing of probably some of how it felt. So there's going to be some serious moments in this because I don't think that, I mean, this was an important moment in the world's history. And I don't think that this kind of war that changes everything, that real people died, I don't really think that's something you should make too big of a joke out of. Now, this isn't going to be Feel City USA or anything, but there is going to be some feel-worthy moments. So anyway, let's hop into it. So, we'll be starting with Storm of Steel. A desperate German breakthrough threatens the position held by the U.S. 369th Infantry, the Harlem Hellfighters. And the Harlem Hellfighters were just a legendary group, for sure. All right, Break of Dawn. Gosh darn, let's go. Self-edit, guys. I don't want to actually swear. I have people that watch my... I got people that watch that don't like swearing, so anyway, not the point. So I self-edit. It doesn't bother me, but it bothers some people, so... We tend to refrain from such things. But unlike the OBS, I can't mute my mic, so you might hear me, but I don't have anything blowing on me, so hopefully... The sound isn't too bad. I also did a sound test beforehand, so our sound test was pretty good. So hopefully the audio should be okay, level-wise. Now, of course, it'll be fixed in subsequent parts if it's not good. Yeah, that's pretty gruesome, man. Battlefield 1 is based upon events that unfolded over 100 years ago. More than 60 million soldiers fought in the war to end all wars. It ended nothing. Yet, it changed the world forever. That's true. What follows is frontline combat. You are not expected to survive. Now, odds are I'll be a little bit rusty, but just like in any shooter, I over time, I adapt. We're surrounded! We have to hold this line! Oh, wow, my buttons are sticky. All right. Ah, I forgot this. So I forgot that in Battlefield, at least Battlefield 1, it also might be in Battlefield 4, but the buttons are updated so that they're normal. They're like a typical shooter. See what I mean? Like, you click the stick, you melee. You hit B, you crouch. That type of thing. Anyway, but yeah, it's like so much more normal. It's so much easier to navigate. I wanted to double check that I was crouching. Boys, we are gonna die here. We're just about out of ammo, kids. We are out of ammo, kids. You guys got any ammo? Oh. It's a single shot weapon. I didn't realize that. Granted, it is much faster to reload. We are dying. I also forgot that you can lean in this game. It's advanced that way. Alright, I can't hit anything when I lean, but you know, it's an imperfect world. Oh dear. Oh, jeez.
Hold it, please!
Oh, kids, we are just about out of ammo. We are officially out of ammo. Ooh, a gun. Oh, and it was ammo for my gun. Nope, never mind. Yeah, it doesn't matter. You're not expected. Rudolph Johnson, 1888 to 1918.
So many of us thinking this war would be our rite of passage, our great adventure. Let me tell you, it was no adventure.
Funny fact, way easier to hit things when you don't zoom in. It sounds funny, but it's true. Oh, heavens! One panic. I mean, you're actually welcome to panic. I don't even blame you. Please reload the weapon. Oh! I got so many, though. Virgil White, 1900 to 1918. He was 18 years old.
Machines, like the tank, changed the shape of the war overnight. Luckily, they were mostly on our side. Mostly.
Our boys in the church are overrun. We need to push through. Keep me on.
Let's hit it.
Counting on us. I saw that guy move. Keep
clear shot on that blasting field gun. You take it. Hold on! We're pushing through!
That guy was close. Oh, that one's a buff. Where?
Good shot! Let's open up for our lad.
Oh, right there, right in front of my face.
Move up with the rest of the armor!
Oh, sorry, boys. Sorry.
Stay focused, men! Push on, damn it! Crawl us through! Fire at anything that moves!
Oh, I will. Yo! Paul something or other. I couldn't really easily get his last name. Fear.
And in war, the only true equalizer is death.
Charge!
No fear. Can't zoom in case you're wondering why I'm not zooming in. With the gas mask on, I can't zoom in.
Airship coming down!
Like I said, I can't zoom in, so let me just get behind this tree. Oh, Dean Stevenson. Sorry, Dean. I wasn't very good. I was trying to get a gun. I ran out of ammo. Whoa! Yipe. He's alive! Oh dear.
They push. We push. Every once in a while, we push hard enough that the light breaks through the cloud. It's in a world beyond the war glimmers. Just out of reach. The war is the world, and the world is the war. But behind every gun sight is a human being. We are those people. We are the jaded, we are the naive, we are the honorable, and the criminal. We are the bound for legend, and the lost to history. We are the knights of the sky, the ghosts in the desert, and the rats in the mud. These are our stories.
There you go, kids, there you go. But like I said, this, it gets really real because it's like, you know, this stuff really happened. You know what I mean? Like, in a lot of the Call of Duty games that we've been playing on my channel, it's like, you know, maybe some parts of it are real. Maybe some parts of it are inspired by something that happened, but it's not the same. You know what I mean? It's not like, it's just a, I don't know. It's not the same. So here it is very much telling a real story. And I think that makes a lot of difference. I don't know why it got me through that. That was kind of weird. Anyway, but so what this game does is, let me go ahead and back it up for a minute. So what this does is, as you can see, that there's all of these. So how it goes through this is it tells these war stories. So basically, I mean, that was the prologue, Storm of Steel. And then it just tells the stories of, you know, individual stories. So there's going to be a lot of difference. We'll be seeing, they're not as long, but obviously we'll be doing them all in order, and I'm not going to title them all different. I'll just tell the whole story, but it doesn't take incredibly long to get through them all, but it's a really cool experience.
My granddad fought in the Civil War. Before I left, he told me what it takes to stay alive, but nothing could have prepared me for what I saw. New machines of war, like the tank, could sometimes change the battlefield overnight. Luckily, they were mostly on our side. Mostly.
So yeah, with each one, it gives you a little synopsis of, like, you know, something that the guy says. And so I wanted to make sure that we saw that. But we're going to be starting with the first one, Through Blood and Mud. We'll be starting with the first mission, Over the Top, which is smash through enemy bases in an MK5 tank, Black Bess. In the MK5 tank, Black Bess. Not A. Black Bess is the name of this particular one, I imagine. Anyway, this is France in the fall of 1918. It is late in the war. Rebecourt? I don't know if I'm probably crushing that. As winter draws in, the Germans fortify their lines and dare the enemy to come to them. Waves of infantry die, crashing against German concrete. The maps do not change. Heavily armed and well-protected, the British MK5 Mark V tank is a fearsome war machine. It clears trenches, it destroys barbed wire, and they can break through. On October 17th, British forces prepare for a mass assault on the town of Cambrai. With tank support, armed command believes a breakthrough is a certainty, but the Mark V tank has one major flaw: it is not reliable. That's true. I mean, a lot of the early tanks were that way. That they were good, but they also were very temperamental. But, you know, and yeah, it's interesting. Interesting. A fun fact, though, is the problem with a lot of the early tanks is when they were hit with something really hard, the bolts on the inside of the tank tended to come loose and fire like bullets inside the tank. So basically, when they got hit with something really hard, they tended to explode and they get hit. So all the little bolts come ricocheting around inside the tank, basically usually killing every guy inside. And so a lot of the early tanks, they had to learn to change how they built the tank. Because they were death traps. If they got hit really, really hard with something, then bad things tended to happen. So it was one of those things that they had to learn to innovate. That, of course, when the tank works, it's of course awesome. You know, they can break through lines and it's a whole new beast on the fields of war or whatever. But obviously that it has the early, you know, the earliest tanks had some serious flaws. And obviously, you know, one of them being that there was, yeah. Obviously, yeah, the early tanks were very unreliable, and that's really the heart and soul of it. But anyway, I guess I will wait until I will probably cut out any more loading screen, because this loading screen is taking an eternity. So I guess I will see you guys in a minute. There we go. Holy crap. So I had to reload the game, because it just didn't ever come back. So I reloaded the game, and this time it worked, apparently. So here we are.
Townsend.
Come on.
You miss all the fun.
All artillery! Fire!
Been looking at your papers.
Don't worry about me, sir. I'm ready to do my bit for King and Country.
Listen, son, you find forward and reverse when you're told you'll do all right for me.
That'll work.
Come and meet Big Bess. Woman of your dreams.
She's so beautiful. There you go. Mark V tank.
And our new driver, boys.
Through Mud and Blood.
sweat. She does not like it when you swear. Finch.
Babes.
You've done this before. I hit my head.
Done what before?
Mind your business with manners. Listen, don't worry. She'll look after you, yeah?
All right, boys. This is the big one. Our orders are to punch through the German line, destroying artillery positions as we go. Finch.
Yes, sir.
That's how you get her started.
After that, we'll advance on the French town of Cambrai, where I have been assured there is wine, women, and song.
So you should enjoy that.
Ha, my man is wine.
Whoa.
Jesus. Are we in safe hands or what, boys?
All right, my man.
Chill, bro, Chacho.
Boys, do your jobs. Take care of each other. Macbeth will take care of you.
May the Lord have mercy on our souls.
We get through this together, right, Edwards?
Watch.
Full ahead, driver!
There we go. Right over the trench. That was something that the tanks were really good at, as they were long enough that they could go right over the top. All right, now hopefully I remember how to do this.
The damn bird is shedding.
Fall in that manners. Bird's mole.
I'll pluck every feather off that damn.
Easy there. That pigeon could save your life. It's our only line of communication.
Get up there, Edward.
Yes. Starting to get the
hang of
it.
Has two weapons, a cannon and a gun, and a machine gun.
Go. A car. I was a chauffeur.
All stop. This is far enough. Infantry will go on the first whistle.
Then we follow.
Heavens above. You ever seen anything like this?
I have. I'm sorry to say it.
Listen. We're going to cut down the guns up by that windmill.
Ah, yes.
Get our boys some room.
All right, new objective. Capture Piccadilly Hill. Now, hopefully, I'm not just a horrible driver. We'll have to see, of course. I don't want to shoot until I see something to actually shoot at.
See that tank, Edwards? Don't get us stuck
Where?
In the mud like that.
Oh, yeah, that one.
Ice front, drive.
Sorry. Oh, the mud, though. There we go. We're good. Just avoid big pockets of mud. Got it. I'm just slowly easing towards him. Trying to tell what's trouble and what's not. Ah, there was something up there. I thought so. I saw that. Tried to hit that machine gun like 5 times.
Enemy.
Please reload, please reload. Oh, we're good. That's an anti-tank grenade! I just remembered that from my time in multiplayer. Oop, oop, oop. Sorry, boys. Excuse me, guys. I don't want to run you over. There we go.
We are right in bed.
Good job, lads. Now we take the next trench line.
We're not very accurate at this distance, but... Alright. I got most of the most dangerous things right there. I saw that. Where was it? There it is.
Field gun is gone.
Ah, it was. It was left button. Press and hold left button. I was trying to remember.
Some lads need support to take the second trench line.
I got it. Hang on, gentlemen. He puts his head up, his toast. Alright, I'm coming. I have a habit of sitting back and just shooting things. Same thing I did it in multiplayer, I did it in all of our Call of Duty games. Campaign playthroughs, I mean. I did try to get better by the end, though. I tried to make it an effort to actually move. So I'm trying to, it'll take me a while to learn it in this one, but we will get it eventually. The habit of actually moving and doing stuff. Flag is blocking my view. Wow, that sucker is really far away. Oh, that's almost perfect. A little more. All right. Let's go. I'm sure it'll come around. It's not him. Oh, there he is. Guys, okay? Oh, I saw that. All right. Oh, overshot. I keep expecting them to be farther back than they actually are. Hang on, I saw another one over here, I thought. Whatever. Hang on, let me just reload for a minute here.
Ruins lie, quickly.
It's a field gun. It's way back there. Give me a minute.
Field gun is down.
I don't have to necessarily see him. I know he's there.
Quickly, shut down that! Hold this position. Mop up the remaining jerrys.
Oops. Whoa!
Should I give the bird some rum?
Too low.
Save the fun and games for when we arrive at Cambrai, boys.
Stand by the guns in aid! Lancer will rip our boys apart. Edwards, gas in! Simmers, go for the south spots! What the hell are you doing? We need to get back into the fight!
Shut up! You want us to take that sucker or not? We're good. I'm fine.
Okay. Is that words? Edwards, you good? You sure?
Oh my gosh! He's not helping anybody anymore. Hang on. We're good. No one in panic.
Village driver, that artillery's holed up there.
He can't see me here. I'm behind this building. Hang on. Let me just... one more. Ow, he hit me again. I know where the shot came from. It's that guy, but he's blocking the road, and I can't get him from... I can't hit him in the armor. I have to hit his soft spots, and I can't.
We're ready to roll again. Get a move on.
Shut up. Okay. I'm assuming this is the cannon. See, he's looking right at me. He always knows. He knows!
Diver, what are you doing? Take us back into the fight!
See, he's waiting for me. What do you want from me? Alright, well, I guess I'll just go straight at him, because apparently fear is for cowards. I'm trying to turn this around. Finally. Hit him in front, they're bloody invincible, apparently. But we're good. We got that guy. Apparently they're invincible in the front, but not in the side. So now we are headed up the streets. Oh dear. I'm getting shot at by a field gun, which I can't ever hit the first time. I still can't hit him.
Stop Jerry hitting us, you idiot.
I'm trying, bro. He's like dug in or something behind the... Nope, still can't hit him. I don't understand what I'm doing wrong. There we go. Got him that time. Gee whiz. There's another one. Let's see. Hey, I got that one first try. I'm so proud. That building saved your life, little field gun. Move a little higher. Gotcha. The first one's a warning shot. It's always important to give a warning shot. Hang on. It's a little bit of overkill, but whatever. I wanted the kill, I guess. Is he dead? Oh, he's dead. All right. We're good. Let's see. This way. Actually, let's just repair me a little bit. We're a little bit low. There we go. Make sure we're on the machine gun. All right.
Blast that gun!
Cannon. Put your head up. Never mind, you don't have to.
Hit it!
I wonder if we can just go right through the building like in multiplayer. Oh yeah. Oh, he's dead. Oh. Hey.
Great job, lads. Let's find the rest.
Give me just a moment. He's turning the field gun in my direction. Nobody panic. We're good.
Field guard! Go! Go! Oh, they're toast!
Yeah, the little tank that's shooting at me. There we go. Now he's toast. Which field gun crew? Oh, well, I can't even see him from over here. Oh, maybe we're not looking at the same thing here. Let me just. I don't think. Not even this tank can climb that wall. Hang on. Watch out, little dude. I want to get up here for better views. That's better. Alright, now we can look for some field guns. A little shallow, a little higher. Alright. That's probably another one, actually. Oh, a little high, a little lower. There we go. Alright, let's go. Whoa, I'm like sideways. Excuse me, gentlemen. You don't mind if I take this objective, do you? There you are. Hey, could you not? There's another field gun right there.
Got it. Now move.
Got him. He's good. Sorry, boys, I did not see him. Hey! Knock it off. Alright, give me a minute. Just gotta patch up. Okay, I'm ready. Let's go. Oh, there we go. Incoming. Oh, dear. I'm sure he's fine. I'm sure he's fine. Nobody panic. Urgh. Think you're really safe in there, huh? Sorry, it's reflex. Hey, knock it off. Oh, hang on. You felt that one. Yeah, not letting you go. I just gotta get out of this bloody trench.
Yes, that will shut them up.
Target destroyed.
Woo! He thinks there was some ammo in there. No survivors. Alright. All's pretty quiet now.
You gotta flatten it, move fast.
Where?
Infantry! Let's calm down!
Oh, way the heck over there. Wow, I actually got a kill. Incredible. Incredible.
Gun's done. Punch it, Edwards.
Is it really? I feel like I barely hit it. Alright, I'm coming. I'm sorry. We've been over this. I gotta get used to moving. What gun? I am not scared of anything. Ah, probably that one.
Edwards, take us over. Clear the bridge of any German defenses.
Good luck taking cover behind your non-existing sandbags anymore, buddy. Something's shooting me in the butt. I can't turn around. If I could turn around, you guys would be dead. Oh, thank you, boys.
More, damn mutt.
I don't want to go through that. Really? That's the plan? Ugh! Why? I can reach it from here. Gonna be honest, I'd rather take my chances trying to snipe it out. Really? Fine. We'll go through the dang mud. Oh, it's this right here. I thought it was the far one. I was like, I don't know why it won't let me hit it. Just push through. Oh, daddy. Come on, baby. Sorry, I hit the mic. That was my bad.
Can't get any traction. Push him back.
Slamming reverse. I told you it was a bad plan.
Come on! Hey, you two mice, you're gonna get us all killed! Ed was behind you!
Ow! Bet you I'm deaf now. Oh! You heard him.
Sir.
I'm back. I'm good. I'm fine. Go, little bird. Well, we're stuck in the mud and being attacked. Pigeon simulator. Is it inverted? Oh, I'm going to die in a hole. It's inverted. Deliver the message to HQ. I'm a pigeon. It's so graceful and peaceful right now. Meow. Pull up, pigeon. It's very, like, delayed. Like, it's supposed to be graceful, okay? So it's very delayed. So that's the reason that it acts kind of weird when I nosedive. Like, could you not focus for just a minute, please? Got it. Focusing. I'm a pigeon. I feel like we must be getting close. Aha. Fire mission. Urgent overrun. And he gave coordinates. That is a big shell. Incoming!
Here it comes, boys. Nice serving with you, lads.
Incoming! Get your body off the door! Thank you. We're alive! They're not. How unexpected. Oh, he's wounded, though.
You have the look of the devil, Townsend. Is that right?
All we got out here is blind orders and chance. Which you'll do first, you reckon?
I'm sick of your lip, McManus.
How about you stow it, bro?
Aye, aye, sir.
It will start it up.
Attempt to start her up anyway. Come on, baby.
Lines backing up.
Give us a break. Give us a break. Come on. Ah, come on, miss. Come on. Stop. Stop, big miss. Stop. Stop. It stopped. Are you just going to stand there?
Okay.
Come on, baby. There we go. She's alive. Freedom. I told you going into the mud was a bad idea. What did I say?
There's fog up ahead. I can't see more than 20 yards.
We're pushing through. Edwards, I'll drive. You jump out and scout ahead.
Oi.
Just do your job.
Okay.
Let's all get through in one piece, eh? If you get into trouble, we'll be right behind you, lad.
Alright. Scout through the forest, clearing anti-tank obstacles ahead of Black Bess. Should you enter combat, Bess will come move up to support you. Okie dokie. Am I the only one who's feeling the spooks? Don't run me over, okay? Only gave me this wee pistol? Could be worse.
God almighty, that's a field gun, Stuart.
I know.
Let's have a recce up ahead. If there's a gun, you'll need to deal with it. If things go south, we'll come in last. Otherwise, we'll bring Bess up when we get the signal.
Okie dokie. Scout the camp, spot enemies, and to identify significant threats. Once combat begins, your job is to keep Bess operational. I'm scared. Anyone else feeling scared? It's foggy. Patrol this way, bro. Chacho, you're gonna eat bullets. Calm yourself, Edwards. I didn't even do that. It just did that on its own. It's like, he's over there. Thanks, game. Think they're being yelled at, or you think they're freaking out that it's me? I'm scared. Stop it, stupid controller. Alright. Fortune favors the bold. I don't know where that other guy went. Aha! Come on, baby. There you go, Edwards. Nice and Dorothy. I'm on the log. Just perched here on the log. Hang on. I got an itch. Sorry. Ow. Alright, we're good. I fell off the log. Panic. Alright, weapon stations are some of the most powerful weapons on the battlefield. Grenade. And a shotgun. Alright, that's really nice. What's this? Dynamite. Hey, we're not kidding. One panic, they've been yelling a lot. I really want to use the field gun against him. Really, really badly.
Hör zu, Arschloch! Konzentrier dich auf deinen Posten!
Yeah, just turn that towards me real quick, idiot. Did you see that, sir? Surely even you can be proud of me. Alright, no more pistol. To the C-96? I don't think so. It wasn't silenced anyway. What's the point? Hang on a minute. You think this one's better? Wow, that is loud. This one's probably better, right? It's a machine gun, isn't it? I don't know. Single fire is pretty nice. Yeah, I'm gonna go with single fire. That went pretty well, I think. Yeah, alright. I'm pretty happy with that. Anything good? Tripwire bomb. Yeah. Don't get too far ahead. Do I get
to carry both, or is it one or the other?
Oh, I definitely need the repair tool. Yeah, that's what I thought. Alright.
Listen, son, I know we're asking a lot here, but this job needs doing. Find us a path through those woods.
Hey man, I wasn't griping at anything. Calm yourself. I know. Okie dokie. I feel like we're not alone in these woods. Well, other than the super spooky graveyard in the middle of nowhere. And a field gun and German positions. But also, super spooky graveyard. That's kind of weird. Another great innovation. Look at this. So if you're behind cover, you can just aim, and it just brings you over the top of it. I could easily end that dude, but I really would love to sneak up and use that field gun against him. It'd be really awkward if one of them comes in behind me. I think he's probably complaining about patrolling. One panic. Wow, that guy is blind. I mean, I know it's hard to see, but still. Freaking out, man. I mean, I'm not freaking out that badly yet. Ooh. Pray tell. Ah, the infamous trench gun. Yeah, I would definitely want my shotgun. Okay, what is this one? Ooh. Alright, I think I probably want this over that. What in the holy... Okay. And I want the shotgun for clearing the trenches, because it's incredibly helpful. Then, of course, your repair tool. Probably in case you switched out of your repair tool earlier. I'm hearing whistling. People only whistle when there's nothing wrong. Oh my gosh, that was just so very close. Yes, come this way, Fraulein. Isn't Fraulein German for woman? Or Mrs.? I almost think it's woman, not Mrs. It could be Mrs. Huh. Idiot. Don't panic.
Halt endlich dein Maul!
Meine Füße bringen mich um.
Okay, he's going that way. I don't have to do this silently, I don't think. Still, though, it makes you feel like... Oh my gosh, he turned around. I think he's going down this way, though. But anyway. Makes you feel like so like a certified ninja if you can creep up on these guys. I hear walking. There's someone behind me, I think. Probably found a body. Anything good? Yeah, no thanks. I remember that from multiplayer. Uh-oh. Methinks me cover's blown. I think there's someone above me and someone way far away. Yeah, there's the guy above me. Don't turn this way. Don't do it. Alright, cover's blown. I was so ready. Get flanked, idiot. I think Bess is in trouble. And I think that field gun's probably on. It's probably where all that chaos is coming from. Stop it. She's fine. Drama Llama.
Tell you what, I'm glad you're on our side, Edwards.
I was a ninja.
We'll deal with this.
I got like 90% of those guys before they even knew what was happening. There was only, I think, what, two guys left? I got all but two of them.
Get up front and lead us through. Don't get too far ahead.
All right. Guide best through the Borlon Woods, maybe? All right. Now, time-wise, yeah, we're getting a little close, so let's try and finish this mission, and then we'll be good. Don't worry, buddy. There's another dead tank. Scurry. Yeah, I think that other set of German guys is afeared from all the explosions and stuff. Because you can see there's a marker up here. I don't know if that guy is freaking out or what. Alright, we might be okay. Alright, so it's a couple of dudes there. And an unknown number of guys farther out. Ooh! No one panic. There's a dude in the tower. The dude in the tower got scared. I would prefer to get as many as we can quietly, so there's less for the... so Bess doesn't get hurt. As much as we can. Easy little German soldier. It's way too out in the open. We'll see if we can sneak to some other guys first. Okay. What we got? Rifle grenade. That could be good. Alright. I am not positive what that is. Is that a shotgun? With that few rounds, almost certainly. I think that was ammo for something. Okay, he is looking this way. Nobody panic. Please don't be two of them. Please only be one. I hear walking. Oh, there's one, but he's already on the prowl. I think he's coming up the path. There he is. That was my bad for walking up to him. I was worried he was going to hear me. So I struck quickly. Ah, there's another pathway. How convenient. What are we looking at here? Just a lot. Essentially. This is like Alpha Base. Alpha German Outpost. There's a guy on that field gun. We need to take him out. Yes, like yesterday. Really hope he's alone here. You often just talk to yourself there, German guy? Well, I would recommend stopping. It's freaking weird. No, I'm kidding. It's not that weird. I do it all the time. Look at that artillery. Oh, daddy. Just jump on this artillery and start shelling everybody ridiculously. Alright, let's maybe creep around to the other side there. There's another guy there, but I think he's facing the other way. And hopefully that's true. Oh, he has to piss. I'm almost positive that's what that means. What else could pissing possibly mean? Shh. He's never gonna have to piss again. It's funny, because I killed him. There's a machine gun. There is one soldier here who's about to eat it. Was that a soldier? Yep. Alright, well, let's go take him out because he's easy pickings. So there's an underground part of it. Repair tool. Oh, turns out the gun wasn't fully loaded. That's pretty funny. Wondering about that. Really happy I looked before I just went for that weapon. Yeah, that's that rifle grenade, but... Ooh, the shovel is a sturdy entrenching tool, sharpened for combat. You can use shovel in close quarters to perform an instant melee kill. Fun. Stick grenade. Yeah, I don't like going out that way. I don't know what that way leads to. This way I feel much more comfortable because I was already out here. Alright, well, I want to work my way up because... Obviously I came from this way, but I want to work this way. I gotta work my way towards that tower. I think anyone's gonna freak out because he was in mid-sentence when I killed him. And do you think his death was obvious? Like, he was like, blah, 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 blah. And then everyone's like, that's not normal. Ooh. Hark, are you a flamethrower guy? You're a dead guy now, scrub lord. Hopefully you can walk up ladders quietly. There's a guy way down there. Okay, there's a guy across the way. I saw that already. Just gonna... quietly... cross the road here. There's a guy over there. What do you think that little marker means? You think it means if I melee him, he's gonna explode? Probably not, right? Is he walking towards me? Nope. I think his back's turned. It is. It is, and now he's a dead guy. I know, it's so cold, or whatever he was saying. Wow, I got everybody, dude. Yes. You see that? Never even heard me. How about that, huh? I found a shovel, I got this fancy shotgun, I'm assuming it's a shotgun. How about that? You didn't even hear me, did you? After you, Bess. I should be in special forces. It's such a waste to use me to use this guy on a, as a tank driver. I thought the enemy whistled. As it turns out, it was me signaling the tank to move forward. That's pretty funny.
According to the map, we should soon be out of these sodden woods.
If we're lucky.
We need to get across this here bridge.
On the bridge! Germans, let them have it!
Germans, get a move on! Move, have our reach! Move, move!
Using it as cover. Alright, that was fun. Oh, it's all green over here. It's so nice. Ah, there was some new stick grenades. That's that one. Open it with that guy's body right there. What? Oh, I know what this is. This is an anti-tank rifle.
Those field guns could quickly ruin our day. You go in, clear out those guns. We'll move up and finish the job.
Alright. Hang on, let me just top off Bess here. Alright. Wow. Can you imagine just being like, boop, and just shooting from here? This is an anti-vehicle weapon designed to penetrate the thickest armor at range. You must lay down or brace yourself against cover to use it. Yeah. That's true to history. That gun actually did very much exist. But what's interesting is this gun was so powerful that when you shot it, it was known to very easily dislocate people's shoulders. True story. Each time you fired it, just pops your shoulder out of place. Pretty redonkulous, if you ask me. It's because they were trying to find a way to penetrate tank armor, and it wasn't going very well. Alright, now I guess we'll try sneaking up this side first. It's a little scary, because I did give up my machine gun for it, for this tank rifle, but I couldn't resist, dude. To make sure I'm not being... there's not enemies, this guy's right here. Alright, some new tank, some new, whatchamadorkits, grenades, ammo for something, and then a trash gun. Okay. Although, you know, in this one, it might be wise to switch my shotgun for the trash gun. I love my shotgun, but I might be in a medium range engagement, and then if all I have is this sniper, we might be in trouble. That's the problem here. Is that guy right there. I could shoot him, but this is not a silent gun. He will know. I mean, everybody will know. He won't know, because he'll be dead immediately. But everyone else will know. I need you to look away, bro, Chacho. Walk away. Thank you. There's a guy way over there, too. Should I, like, try and walk up these and, like, jump across or something? It seems like a... Yeah, I don't think that was a good plan. Dangerous, 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 dangerous. Dangerous, dangerous, dangerous. You just calm down, Rubber Chicken. I don't know why his name is Rubber Chicken. I know there's a guy way over there, but I'm worried that the sniper dude will see me if I creep in there. Oh, it's the tank rifle again. The This door doesn't open, does it? Nope. Wow, it's loud in here. Ah, yeah, no thanks. Dynamite, I already have it. I would love to just go melee this dude. This sniper boy right here? Here's hoping. Oh, he's right there. Oh my gosh. I just saw his little head move. Why is it so loud in here? What am I walking on? Oh, bet you that guy, he's yelling at the dead people. Maybe. That's the thing, is I gotta find a way to get up and around. Without Sniper Boy giving away my position. You hear, Sniper Boy? I'm just literally trapped in here now. To switch to rocket gun? What the heck is this? Ah! Interesting. Oh, it switches it for the repair tool. That's weird. It is a powerful anti-vehicle weapon. You must lay down and brace it. Yeah, I already got one of those. Thank you. I don't know what to do, kids. I would love to just kill that dude. I gotta get across, but... I don't know what to do! Because I feel like he's definitely gonna see me if I leave. Maybe we'll have better luck on this side. Oh dear. Oh, he didn't see me for sure. Alright, turns out he's not marked on the map, which is a thing. But if he could get down here, I would love that, because then I could just melee him inside here, which would be great. Okay, I was trying to figure out how to get farther away, but alas. Come around the corner. Come on. Oh, here he comes, kids. Here he comes. Maybe. Here he comes. He's almost here. Oh, he's right around right on the other side of the wall. If he walks away, I'm gonna have to jump him anyway. Oh my gosh, that was close. Now I have to make my move, even if I get caught. Because this guy is the only thing stopping me from being able to easily just... going to where I'm going. Ooh, now I would love to switch from this sniper for this sniper. Yes. That guy sounds like a smoker. Don't you... This is it. Ah! Just look at the corner right as he fired at me. There he is on the other side of that. Right there.
Wrong button. Yeah, suck on that, tank. I got him. I, you know, crapped myself, but I got him. Remember, I'm over here too, guys. Like what? I got the tank. What did you guys do? Here they come. Hang on, I need the... Yeah, I actually do need this now. I heard another tank. Yeah, I got that kill, son. He's dead. Wow, this gun's recoil is aggressive. Gotcha. Bayonet charge for the win. Uh-oh. Where'd he go? Oh, you see that? What a shot, though. See that? Oh my gosh, so proud of that. Just listen to the echo on that gun, though. I'm so proud. I'm coming.
Get in and drive, Edwards. Let's get out of here.
Hang on. I don't know if it matters, but it's the right thing to do.
That was outstanding, Edwards. You'll have yourself a medal if we get through this.
Yeah, I know it was. I'm freaking practically special forces that went so well. Turns out the anti-tank sniper actually pretty stinking incredible. Which, you know, you shouldn't be surprised, but... Okay. So as soon as I can, I will open the menu. As I'm pretty sure this is our last mission of this chapter, so... But we are out of time for sure.
So she needs new spark plugs.
Check.
Check how far that village is. Can you see it, Sam? Can you see the village?
Actually, this might be... That only might have been the second mission. I actually think there's this one and one more. Or maybe it's one long mission. I think it's two, though.
Edwards?
Yeah. But they're not ours anymore.
Sounds like whatever Bess needs is down in that village. All right. Let's go, Everett. Let's go. Good luck.
Tank is going nowhere and he'll be dead by morning. We're fucked.
What's it, you? You're just gonna abandon him, are you? Don't you get it? Finch, Pritchard, all of us. We've been fucked all along.
Look, that's what you want, McManus. Then just go. Don't you ever talk to me like that. I've ran more fucking missions than you have had hot dinner, son.
McManus, just fucking go.
Good riddance, coward. Alright. Really quick, just want to see what they gave me.
Together.
Oh, I have the same guns.
Find the parts. Get the tank running. Don't die.
Exactly. How hard could that possibly be? Turns out they gave me the same guns. I also have the same ammo, I might point out, though. So that's something that is a thing. Anyway, but I think this will probably perfectly call where we are at. So let's just take a quick backup, and we'll see how many more missions we have left. But I think we have, like, that one, and I think there's one more. It's either that or it's one very long mission. I think it's probably two, though, because it feels, even if it is long, that it feels way too long. So I'm thinking it probably has to be two. Let's go ahead and check here. Yes, okay, so that we did two. We did two of them, so now we will have two more. So I don't know if each one will be... I don't know if each mission will be... Yeah, so I think we'll probably be able to get done both of those in the next video. But we are definitely out of time for this one. I am probably going to... I don't know if I will cut out a lot of the stealth stuff. Because there was, I don't know, and like a lot of it was fine. But especially in the second one, I was trying really hard to figure out how to get to where I needed to go. So I might make some trimming, but all in all, I don't think it'll be too much cut. But anyway, this is where we are going to call today's episode. I'm having a lot of fun. I forgot how fun this campaign was. And I'm having a blast. And also the innovations, like being able to hit B and crouch and being able to tap, you know, the melee button and have it actually do the melee. Like, I'm really happy that they fixed the controls, because I forgot that the Battlefield 3 controls were different and they were not nearly as good. But anyway, and I am really sorry once again that our Battlefield 3 campaign video is scrapped. I am really sorry about that. The unfortunate reality is that it's corrupted. So unless we do it in one sitting, we won't get it back. So there's nothing I can do. There's no way to retrieve it. It's just that my game has always been broken and it's always done that. So anyway, but I hope you guys can be happy that we are replacing that one with this. So at least you are getting a Battlefield game represented. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the content today, and we will talk to you guys later. Hey guys, Darth Clark here.
Oh my gosh, though, what an upset. Darius is like, forget your type advantage, scrub. And look at that stat line.
Ooh,
sexy. This is your chance, my dude.
It's tear gas. Reznov, save me.
Everyone's rushing. Let's rush, too.
You could say we're rushing to the objective.
I'm so sorry.
I'm going to shoot your little toes.
You think PETA's going to come after me for just executing these monkeys for literally no reason at all? Shoot at me. So oh, my gosh. Be careful what you wish for, kids.
Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the content today, and we will talk to you guys later.